U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo issues a stern warning to China. She says American businesses are losing patience with Beijing, adding these companies deserve a predictable environment and a level playing field. The Commerce Chief notes U.S. firms faced new challenges in doing businesses in the second largest economy in the world. Among them, unexplained large fines, raids, and changes to a counter-espionage law. Raimondo says she brought this up, as well as the hacking of her email when she recently met top Chinese officials in Beijing. China's economy is grappling with a slowdown that has rattled the global markets. Asian markets getting a boost at the start of the week. Property stocks in Hong Kong powering the Hang Seng after Chinese developer Country Garden secured creditors' approval over the weekend to extend onshore private bond payments worth $540 million. Some key data to watch out for this week. The Reserve Bank of Australia's rate decision on Tuesday, which will be Governor Philip Lowe's final policy meeting. China's trade balance figures for August also out this Thursday. Looking at the major stock indices now, the Hang Seng up by a significant 2.5%, with the Shanghai Composite following the lead. The ASX 200 also climbing by more than half of a percent on the eve of the RBA's rate decision. In share price movements, we're seeing shares of Japan's SoftBank Group down by 1.3%. That's after the chip designer asked investors to pay as much as $51 each for its shares when it begins marketing its initial public offering. The price is expected to translate into valuation of Arm of up to $54 billion. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are mirroring gains in Asia. Contracts for London's FTSE 100, German DAX, and the French CAC 40 are up about a fifth of a percent each. Investors in the region are also assessing data from Germany, which showed a trade surplus in Europe's biggest economy narrowed in July as exports fell less than expected, while imports jumped. As for Wall Street, U.S. markets are closed for the Labor Day holiday. Philippine Trade Chief Alfredo Pascual stressing the need for an enabling environment for recovery in the ASEAN region that prioritizes both sustainable and inclusive growth. Pascual urged the region to translate the endorsed elements in the ASEAN Vision 2045 into tangible investments in green technologies, renewable energy, and climate-resilient infrastructure to boost economic activities while not compromising the environment. He made a pitch at the special retreat session of ASEAN Economic Community Council ministers in Jakarta. During the event, the ministers tackled the region's economic performance and outlook and provided guidance on the ASEAN post-2025 vision and blueprint.
Now for some local corporate stories. Fast food giant Jollibee Foods Corporation completes its purchase of majority stake in its brand's master franchisee in Hong Kong, Mecco Holdings Limited. JFC subsidiary Golden Plate PTE will acquire 60% of the shares from the shareholders of Mecco, amounting to around $16 million. This move is part of its expansion plans in Hong Kong. For the Ayala Group's energy arm, ASIN, it raised 25 billion pesos from its maiden peso-denominated preferred shares offer. They were earlier listed on the main board of the local bourse last September 1st and were publicly offered from August 11 to 23. The offer is the first tranche under ASIN's shelf registration of up to 50 million preferred shares. ASIN has said the funds will be used to finance its new or existing eligible green projects. And finally, Meralco energizes a new smart substation in Taguig City. The move is to ensure stable power for Arca South Development, an Ayala Land real estate project, and its neighboring communities. The power distributor adds the Arca South substation aims to improve voltage regulation in Taguig and provide operational switching flexibility during calamities. Arca South is envisioned to be the central business and lifestyle district in southern Metro Manila.
New York Times best-selling author Malcolm Gladwell is in Manila for a tenant partners summit of SM Supermalls. Lady Vicencio joins us on the line to tell us more. Lady?
Yes, Stanley, the Asian journalist. Malcolm Gladwell shared a glimpse of his take on various concepts in a brief press conference held in Pasay City this morning. The New York Times best-selling author willingly answered questions on labor, specifically on pressing concepts such as artificial intelligence in the workplace. When asked if AI is a threat to human labor, Gladwell said he believes that AI is intended instead to make humans smarter. He also added that AI should lessen the burden of data role and in the best case scenario would allow humans to carry out tasks that machines cannot do, such as resolving personal conflicts and appealing to emotions. Gladwell also took the opportunity to clarify his criticism on remote work, which he said became quite controversial. In a podcast last year, Gladwell regarded remote work as not in the best interest of companies and employees. But he clarified that his views are more targeted to industries that need collaborative work among employees. He also stressed that while he recognizes the hardships of some employees in reporting to office, such as commuting or parenting, he also emphasized that the challenge lies on how flexible employees and employers can be and to determine how working in the office is the most productive way to utilize time. Gladwell is expected to share more of his insights as the keynote speaker for a tenant partner summit of mall operator and developer SM Super Malls. The retail business is now even better than pre-pandemic levels as people are now coming back to the malls as the holiday season kicks off and with the opening of classes. With increased demand, Tan also said that they are opening 7 shopping centers until next year, together with the expansion of their online retail platforms to give consumers their more choices for their shopping needs. Tan Lee?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Lady Vicentro.
A California tech startup is utilizing artificial intelligence to reduce discrimination. But as this report tells us, some are concerned that diversity among workers in the industry is being erased.
In the global economy, a call to a customer service center will likely be answered by someone in a faraway part of the world.
Just bear with me for a moment.
Call center workers can train for months to effectively communicate with customers whose native language and culture differ from theirs.
Okay, try that. Photographer. Good.
Despite this training, accents often get in the way, says developer Sharath Narayana.
There are at least a few instances every single day of his life or her life that they go through some level of discrimination and sometimes straight up abuse.
Narayana is a co-founder of California-based Sanus AI, whose technology can adjust the way a speaker sounds, with the goal of making an accent more relatable. A call center worker from the Philippines demonstrated.
Hi, my name is Iggy. I'm from Parañaque.
Hi, my name is Iggy. I'm from Parañaque.
The difference can be subtle, but Narayana says it is helping call center workers avoid abuse.
We are not trying to hide the fact that this person is from India or this person is from the Philippines, but this person would sound so clear, so confident, and so crisp that the other person would like to have a conversation.
Discrimination and abuse by callers are among the factors leading to high turnover among call center workers. Narayana himself once worked in such a center. And although he doesn't excuse the behavior of callers, he says he understands what's going on.
When they hear that accent, the first thing that I see is that lack of trust with this person. Hey, I waited so long for my problem to solve. Now I'm connected to somebody that I can't relate to, or his voice that I cannot relate to. Can this person actually solve my problem?
Sociologist Anish Anish says tools like Sanus can help reduce the burden on call center agents. Anish, however, worries that it also points to what he says are dehumanizing trends in technology, namely erasing diversity.
Most of our communication is mediated through some technology. But when technology starts changing your accent itself, that is transforming you into your own avatar, now the driving force is not developing an understanding between human beings, but the driving force is transactional, in the sense that things have to get functionally done.
Narayana says that of the workers with the optional Sanus system installed, 97% of them are choosing to use it every day.
because I was able to listen to one of my calls using Sinus, and wow.
It looks like English is my first language, wherein in fact it's not.
If there is a technology solution to it, where I don't have to change the way I sound, but the other person can understand me very, very clearly, why isn't it a beautiful thing?
For now, the AI seems to be helping people connect. Matt Dibble, VOA News, Palo Alto, California.
In today's numbers that matter, 96.9 billion pesos, that's the amount of subsidies that the national government gave to state firms as of end July. The figure is 17% higher than last year's 83 billion pesos. State insurer PhilHealth got the largest subsidy at 37.6 billion pesos. It was followed by the National Irrigation Administration with 25.8 billion and the Power Sector Assets and Liabilities Management Corporation with 5 billion.